At what point in the first quadrant does a line with equation y equals 2x plus 1 intersect the circle with radius 4 and center 0 comma 4? And we're asked to round to 3 decimal places. So graphically, we're looking for this point of intersection here in the first quadrant. We take a look at the line first. Notice how it does have a y-intercept of positive 1. And from here, if we go up 2 units and right 1 unit, we're still on the same line, verifying the slope is positive 2. Then looking at the circle, notice how it has a center of 0, 4, and the radius is 4 units. So we're going to begin by determining the equation of the circle and then solve this as a system of equations. So using this equation of a circle, because the radius is 4 and the center is 0, 4, h is 0 and k is 4, which means the equation of the circle would be the quantity x minus 0 squared, or just x squared, plus, again, k is 4, so we have the quantity y minus 4 squared equals r squared, which would be 4 squared, or 16. Now we know the linear equation is y equals 2x plus 1. So again, we're going to solve this now as a system of equations, and we're going to use substitution. Notice here, y equals 2x plus 1, so we'll make this substitution for y in the first equation. We'll substitute 2x plus 1 here for y. So this would give us the equation x squared plus the quantity 2x plus 1 minus 4 squared equals 16. Let's go ahead and simplify this. We'd have x squared plus the quantity 2x, this would be plus 1 minus 4 is minus 3 squared equals 16. Notice now we have an equation with one variable. So now we'll expand this, combine like terms, and solve the equation. So we'll have x squared plus the quantity 2x minus 3 times the quantity 2x minus 3 equals 16. Here we'll have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we'll have x squared, and then plus 4x squared. The next product would be minus 6x, but then we have another minus 6x, that's minus 12x, and then plus 9. X squared plus 4x squared would be 5x squared. Then we have minus 12x plus 9 equals 16. We have a quadratic equation, so we're going to set it equal to 0 and see if it factors. So we'll subtract 16 on both sides. That would give us 5x squared minus 12x. If we subtract 16 on both sides, that's going to give us minus 7 equals 0. Unfortunately, this is not factorable. So now we'll have to solve this using the quadratic formula. And keep in mind, we're looking for the point in the first quadrant, so we're only concerned about the positive solution to this equation. Remember, when using the quadratic formula, we'll have a equals 5, b equals negative 12, and c equals negative 7. Keep in mind, we are asked to round the coordinates of the point of intersection to 3 decimal places. Let's go ahead and solve this on the next slide. Here's the quadratic formula if we need the review. We would have x equals negative negative 12 plus or minus the square root of b squared, that's negative 12 squared, minus 4 times a, which is 5, times c, which is negative 7. We'll divide all this by 2 times a, or 2 times 5. So we have x equals positive 12 plus or minus the square root of, this would be 144 plus 140, that's 284, divided by 10. Now we don't need to simplify this because we're looking for a decimal value rounded to 3 decimal places. But we are looking for the positive value of x in the first quadrant, which means we're looking for the decimal approximation for x equals 12 plus the square root of 284 divided by 10. But just in case you were curious, 284 is equal to 4 times 71, so that would be 12 plus or minus the square root of 4 times 71 divided by 10, or 12 plus or minus 2 square root 71 divided by 10. And then to simplify this, we could break it up into two separate fractions, 12 tenths plus or minus 2 square root 71 divided by 10, which would give us 6 fifths plus or minus square root 71 divided by 5. And of course we could write this as a single fraction if we wanted to. But again, for our purposes, we're only concerned about the decimal approximation of this to three decimal places. So using a calculator, so we'd have open parenthesis for the numerator, 12 plus the square root 284, close parenthesis for the square root, another one for the numerator, and then divided by 10. So x is going to be approximately 2.885. Notice how the fourth decimal place is a 2, indicating we round down. So x is approximately 2.885. We still have to find the y coordinate though. We know that the point of intersection in the first quadrant has an x coordinate that's approximately 2.885. And now to find the y coordinate, we'll perform back substitution. Let's go ahead and use the linear equation, which was y equals 2x plus 1, to find the y-coordinate. So we'd have y equals 2 times 2.885 plus 1, which comes out to y equals 6.770. So this would be the y-coordinate of the point of intersection. And again, keep in mind, these have been rounded to three decimal places. So going back to our graph, this does seem to verify what we see graphically. The x-coordinate does appear to be a little bit less than 3, and the y-coordinate does appear to be less than 7. I hope you found this explanation helpful.